We see that heating a house with solar energy only requires more than 20 square meters of solar collectors, but the precise answer about their area is given by a similar table. This heat production by solar collectors must be greater than this heating needs of a house for each month if the house does not have a gas boiler or other heating source. It is obvious that these heating needs and this number of sunny days depend on the climate, and the American winter is sunnier and colder than in Europe for the same latitude. You may think that this area of solar collectors, 48 square meters, is too much and expensive, but this video will describe an innovation which reduces this area of solar collectors and their cost by approximately 2 times. The traditional method involves using this tank for several tons of water which are heated by solar radiation, and then, in the evening and at night, this hot water is used to heat the house. But our innovation suggests using 3 tanks with water of different temperatures, and this heat exchanger can transfer heat from this antifreeze of solar collectors to the water of any of the tanks. It is well known that solar collectors are not capable of heating such hot water in the morning hours, and therefore we use them to heat this coldest tank. Then they will heat this water, and midday is the time of heating this hottest tank. After this, the solar collectors heat this tank again, and the evening hours allow heating only this coldest tank. Thanks to this, the heat production of solar collectors increases, and this is an example of one sunny day with this time from morning to evening. This is heat production by the traditional method for that single tank of this temperature. But this is heat production according to our innovation, and this is heat for the coldest tank of this temperature, and this is heat for the other 2 tanks, and this is for the hottest tank. We see that the heat production has increased due to the decrease in this water temperature, which increases the efficiency of the solar collectors. These are the widely known heat storages with thermal insulation, and the first tank is used for hot water supply all 12 months of the year, but the second tank has a similar pipe to transfer heat to this water of the home heating system. The third tank is several times larger for 2 tons of water, which gives thermal energy to the input of this small heat pump, whose output gives heat to the same water of the home heating. This is a similar cheap tank without thermal insulation, and it can also be used as a rainwater collection tank or cold water reserve. This is the power of heat output from a solar collector during one sunny day from the sunrise to the sunset, and this is the time of connection of the solar collector with the coldest tank. But January has such a feature when this heat production for the coldest tank is longer, and this heat production for the other 2 tanks lasts only 3 hours, but it will be about 4 hours in December. In addition, similar non-ideal sky is accompanied by the heat production only for the coldest tank, but such a small percentage of clouds can allow the heat production for the other 2 tanks. Moreover, such low temperatures of the coldest tank sometimes allows its heating during cloudy weather, which was described in this my old video, which also showed an experiment when this cloudy sky heated the water to 28 degrees Celsius. Let's place our house near this American city, Albuquerque, which has this climate during 5 months of its heating season. These ambient temperatures determine the heating needs of a house with an area of 100 square meters, and this is the heat production from 23 square meters of solar collectors for those 2 hot tanks in December and January. This is the production of heat by the same solar collectors for the 3rd tank, and this energy will be converted by the heat pump with this electricity consumption. The heat pump has a high efficiency because this average water temperature at its inlet is high. The difference between this inflow of thermal energy and this its outflow gives this excess energy, which goes to hot water supply from this 1st tank. But February is different, and this work of the heat pump is several times less due to the following 2 reasons. Firstly, the operating time of the solar collectors for those 2 hot tanks increases to approximately 7 hours in February. Secondly, such a sky with clouds of about 50% gets the right to produce heat for those 2 hot tanks. These two trends increase in the remaining months, and therefore this month heat the house without the heat pump and they have so much excess energy for hot water supply or other applications. This is the cost of our entire system for home heating and hot water supply. It is a little more expensive than traditional systems, but free solar energy saves almost $1,000 annually on hot water for 12 months and another $500 annually on home heating from November to March. This second tank should strive to get rid of all its energy during the evening and night in order to reach this minimum temperature in the morning in order to increase the efficiency of the solar collectors. The third tank stores heat reserves, and this method allows its thermal energy to be transferred to the second tank to heat the house. All three tanks store a reserve to heat the house for two non-sunny days in a row, which is enough for Albuquerque, where the sun shines as often in winter as it does on Spanish beaches in the summer months. A sunny period in January can heat the tanks to these temperatures, and you can calculate that cooling them to these minimum temperatures heats the house for 3 nights and 2 cloudy days. After this, we can periodically turn on this pump, which will allow the house to be heated for almost another day.